can you do? Can you do? What a doer, what a dream come a doer, what can you do? From the broom skin cap on the top of old Dan to the heel of his ball white shoe. The rippin'est, roarin'est, fightin'est man the frontier ever knew. Daniel Boone was a man, yes, a big man. And he fought for America to make all Americans free. But Daniel Boone was a man, yes, a big man. And he fought for America to make all Americans free. What a boom, what a doer, what a dream come a doer was he.
This generation of Americans has a rendezvous with destiny.
But right now, we have a rendezvous with hysteria!
Hysteria presents The World War III, starring the presidential chuckles, Abraham Lincoln as Abe.
47 years ago was the last time I got a bill for Congress.
First Lady of the United States, Mary Todd Lincoln as Invisible Girl. Now you see, now you don't.
I'll show you a real civil war.
Abraham Lincoln's horse name, Truth Seeker. The son of Abraham Lincoln, Robert Todd Lincoln as Robert Tough Lincoln, the Human Torch. The Assassinator, John Wilkes Booth as John Wills Bow.
It's clobbering time!
And 20th century superhero writer, Ernest Hemingway.
That's no bull.
And now, the Chief of Chuckles, Honest Abe Lincoln!
47 years ago was the last time I got a bill through Congress. You know, to fish or own a dog, you need a license, but anyone can run for president. It's like I say, the presidency is an institution, and all presidents should be in one. And my poor wife, Mary, can't take the pressure in Washington. She said she thinks that her mind is going. I'm not surprised. She's been giving me a piece of it every day for the last 22 years. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a great show for you today. Coming up next on
Hysteria!
It's extremely collaborative. We start with a script from our writers, and we'll begin to visualize that kind of a comic strip form up on a storyboard. And then we'll pitch that to each other. The story artist will get up and kind of go through it.
Comes back and dresses Esmeralda.
That story meeting becomes a great chance for the directors to say, yeah, that's a little slow in here, and I don't like that line of dialogue, and what if we added a gag here? That process allows us to work out a lot of the bugs. The great thing about it is we're all under one roof. So you can run upstairs and have a story meeting, you can run downstairs and look at film, run across the hall and have lunch. And with that comes a great stew of creativity happening. It gives a chance for people to get away from the drawing board for a few hours and go out and blow off some steam.
Lee moved his army across the Potomac, through Maryland, and on into Pennsylvania.
Today on Hysteria, we'll see if that's true.
Hey, lady, I need a book!
Well, if your outfit needs a little pressing, you're in luck. Now, let's move on to the really important part of our tour. It's easy. Doctors simply enter your skull and remove pesky bone matter without damaging your brain's fibrous membrane.
And now, this!
Basically the story of Quasimodo, who's a human outcast, who's been raised his whole life in the bell tower of Notre Dame by the sinister stepfather. There's nothing that Quasi wants more than to be part of the outside world, and his desire is so great that it eventually draws him out of the bell tower, where he meets the beautiful gypsy girl Esmeralda and the knight Vidas.
During the 1869, Geardrum Strong Guster has decided to hunt the buffalo for Hayes, a Kansas. He was hunting them that cannot be dead.
Between you and me, young'uns, it weren't the Indians
means that we're doing the breaking.
Alright! That sounds like the buffalo herds are coming over to the Fort Hays. And now I'm going to hunt them down with some kind of weapons. The weapons I got on my hands.
Well, my friend, you can kiss your simple country ways goodbye. Because it's time for Meet the Megalomaniacs. And here's our host, Miss Information.
Hi, y'all. We're sniffing something that is not springtime fresh.
Do not mock me! Okay, Loud, tell us about our first...
Miss Information! Tell her what she's chosen!
Well, Sarah, if your outfit needs a little pressing, you're in luck, because you've selected
the Crushing!
No way! I don't even look like a...
All right, never mind. All right, Misinformation, tell me, how do I decide to capture the Indians outside the forest?
Since there was no law enforcement in the area, the place was popular with bandits, smugglers, claim jumpers, and horse thieves.
You rock, man! I mean, woman? That was awesome! In fact, in 1869, I decided to go hunt buffalo with my gun at Fort Hays. If you excuse me, little woman.
Hey, mister! We heard that there's a custard stand here and we want some! So how about some custard, mister? So that would make this a custard stand, right?
Oh my, fortunately we've run out of time. But before we go, I'd like to bring out a special guest.
Ranger Lloyd Kennington at your service!
Yeah, I'd like to hire some rangers like Lyle Kennington and Susanna. You better stop hunting the buffaloes in the territory. And then you give me your gun at once! I'll never give you a gun of mine, you coward!
Gee, I thought it was kind of cute. Those gunfighting dentists can be downright ornery, can't they? And that's why we love them!
If you need a battle cry, call it Loud.
Of only battle cries, I'm supreme.
If you want to beat the South, here's...
I think what interested us in the story to begin with was Quasimodo. Here you have this character which Victor Hugo literally put between heaven and hell. He's trapped up in the bell tower of Notre Dame, whose dilemma was to get outside and have his day in the sun.
Oh, you can't say that. That word is a no-no.
What?
Hello, I'm Lydia Karaoke Network Censor. Sorry, but we're having a little problem with your choice of words.
And I want you to watch it.
The year? 1862. The place? North Carolina. The war between the states was in full swing.
After the Battle of Shiloh, the Johnny Shaw legend appears instead of stemmed from the popular Civil War song, The Drummer Boy of Shiloh, by William S. Hayes. On the September of Battle of Chickamauga, during the Union retreat, he shot the Confederate colonel who had demanded his surrender. But on the WB, he decided to declare war on the Confederate States to win the war, which he decided to become John Foster's best friend.
Unfortunately, Abe wasn't happy with General McClellan's overly cautious nature and his reluctance to fight the enemy.
Hey, Johnny Shiloh, my drummer boy. Good work drumming around. I have good news for you today. We decide you to become the cavalry of the Unions with your friends on your WB and explore to declare war on the Goldsboro.
Whoa, I didn't know it was going to be multiple choice. I should have studied. Excellent! Well, clearly dirt has no lips. All dirt tricks are aerials, naturally. But admit it, aerial bikage is the meaning of life, am I right?
Report hand for duty, sir.
Right, that's all quite all right, but we shall talk about the Goldsboro Expedition. We shall declare war on the Goldsboro after the December 1416.
Yo, Toast, have you seen Big Fat Baby?
Negatory. And there's no wreckage.
Lucky Bob, have you seen Big Fat Baby?
Yes, now.
No, wait. That revolt idea rocks! The first thing we gotta do is get rid of the enemy leaders, Trey and Nasty.
Enemy leaders, also known as Jefferson Davis, leader of Confederates. So, I want my Union troops to sign up this contract, so I want everyone to be led by John Foster. So I need to know where John Foster was. Where is John? There you are, John!
If you need a battle cry, call it loud.
Of only battle cries, I'm supreme!
If you want to beat the South,
here's Chief Omega Mel!
Call it loud, call it loud, call it loud!
Oh good, you're in charge. If I were you, I'll let you lead your drummer boy and your sidekicks Lucky Bob, Cho-Cho, to the Ghost Ball.
Hello, Lincoln. I'm Spock, Captain James Kirk's friend from Star Trek. I have a question for you. Am I in the sketch?
No.
The date, December 14th, 1862. The event, the Battle of Kinston. Every Confederate at North Carolina likes to declare war a lot, but the Union, led by John G. Foster, doesn't want them a lot.
We're all finished, Coach!
Yeah?
Yup, the job is done!
I call him Stairs in a Mirror.
On December 16th, at the Battle of Whitehall, this fight was to draw quite white.
I did what I could.
It could be, perhaps, that their dress were too tight, and I think they always hide in the stables behind the wall, while the Confederate States was three sizes too small.
Don't worry, Pop. While you've been in the hospital, I kept working on the monument. See?
Well, my number's like a lot higher.
On December 17th at the Battle of Goldsboro Bridge, little Confederate Boo-Hoo went on tight, dressed in the Crazy Witch.
On the 12th day of Christmas, not jolly gift to me! 12 turtledoves, 11 turtledoves, 10 turtledoves, 9 turtledoves, 8 turtledoves, 7 turtledoves, 6 turtledoves, 5 turtledoves, 4 turtledoves, 3 turtledoves, 10 turtledoves, and we're pretending the kicks are turtledoves.
And finally, welcome Christmas. Bring your cheer. We'll come along is far and near. Christmas Day it always be. Just a snore as we have we. Welcome Christmas while we stand. Heart to heart and hand to hand.
All finished! Your wall is done! Check it out, Coach!
A 10 hot dudes. Adios. Right, bros? Your bikes are ready for inspection. No doubt, you'll find them full-on killer.
Peace now.
Thanks to Johnny Shalaw and John G. Foster, the world's greatest Goldsboro expedition came to an end during the Civil War. The war's not a civil, it's uncivil for Johnny Shalaw. It was uncivil war for him. Well, goodbye, Merry Christmas!